This is breaking news.
Today, we are closing the market for military-grade assault motorcycles in Canada.
We interrupt this remaining broadcast of The National to bring you this long-awaited announcement from our Supreme Leader, Justin Trudeau. Making true to their promise, the federal Liberals have moved to ban performance semi-automatic sport motorcycles in a pressing desire to make our streets safer. Realistically, the ban narrows primarily to 7 models of sport bikes that show a rather similar design and color. Their characteristic sleek lines of aggression have shown great popularity amongst the motorcycle community for some time now, while sport biking has been on the rise.
Their families deserve more than thoughts and prayers. Canadians deserve more than thoughts and prayers.
These sport bikes in the wrong hands can potentially shoot to a speed of 100 kilometers per hour in 2 seconds and can produce a kinetic energy output of mass and top velocity, transferring to a potential vehicular crash energy output in excess of 1.5 million joules. The majority of Canadians have long awaited this ban announcement, as polling numbers have shown in recent months.
We are banning 1,500 models and variants of these
performance motorcycles
by way of regulations. These
machines
were designed for one purpose and one purpose only: to
get from one place to another
in the shortest amount of time. But you don't need
a Kawasaki Ninja to ride around here.
This announcement comes just weeks after the horrible and unprecedented accidents that have taken place in Nova Scotia. Multiple lives in a rather short time span were either lost or severely wounded. Our Canada's own sister state television affiliate will now bring you this special report.
A motorcyclist has lost his life after crashing in Lower Sackville last night. It is the second fatal motorcycle accident on a maritime road just this week. And CTV's Natasha Pace finds the RCMP say they are seeing more collisions this year than last.
RCMP say they're concerned about an increase in collisions involving motorcycles so far this year.
From January 1st until yesterday, this particular year, we've had 25 motorcycle collisions, 2 of which were fatalities. Now, the same time period last year, there were 16 motorcycle collisions and no fatalities, so the numbers are up.
Around 6 o'clock last evening, RCMP say a teenager lost control of the motorcycle he was riding in Lower Sackville. He left the road and died at the scene.
The victim was 19 years old. It was a young man from the Lower Sackville area.
The name of the victim hasn't been released. RCMP say they're working to determine what led to the fatal collision. With more motorcycles on the roads, experts say it's important for riders to be well prepared for any situation. As for last night's collision in Lower Sackville, RCMP say a collision analyst did attend the scene and officers are still working to piece together exactly what happened. Steve?
Halifax Regional Police investigating another serious accident involving a motorcycle in the city. Police were called to Victoria Road and Highway 111 just before 2 o'clock today after a bike collided with a car and was then hit by a van. Man on the motorcycle, a 30-year-old from Dartmouth, was rushed to hospital with life-threatening injuries. Police say the investigation is in its early stages. There's no word on possible charges yet. Traffic in the area was blocked and rerouted for much of the afternoon. Anyone who may have seen the crash is asked to contact HRP.
Although these accidents primarily result from illegal use, lawfully abiding sport bike owners are disappointed with this announcement, calling it undemocratic, as this ban was pushed through by an order in council rather than debated in Parliament. Before this ban, lawfully abiding sport bike owners would have to go to a racetrack under close and careful supervision to use their sport bikes as they were intended. But because of criminal misuse and abuse on our roads that already have strict regulations, roads that need special licensing and training, the federal Liberals feel an all-out ban will reduce the carnage and wrongful deaths of hundreds of Canadians annually. Lawfully abiding sport bike owners point to the illegal street use of these motorcycles, portrayed and glorified in hundreds of YouTube videos. Videos which primarily come from the United States, then coming up to Canada by illegal impressions of our youth, causing gangs of these rebel motorcyclists to perform horrific acts, as our Canada's own sister state-run television affiliate reports here.
Police in Ontario are trying to bust a new kind of biker gang tonight that's taking over some of Canada's busiest highways. A motorcycle mob went on a joyride around Toronto, performing high-speed stunts and paralyzing traffic. CTV's John Venevelli Rao with the high-speed chase.
In this video posted online, the bikers seem to revel in their accomplishment, hijacking a major highway, bringing traffic to a standstill, angering both motorists and police, who from above captured the reckless riders and their motorcycle mayhem.
This is an activity that is putting public safety at risk.
The swarm creating chaos last Sunday afternoon, intimidating drivers like Julie Bueller, who was with her family, including two young children, when their car was suddenly overtaken.
Constantly cutting you off, you just want to get out of the way and you can't because there were just so many of them.
Ontario Provincial Police say the riders slowed traffic on several highways and performed stunts, some obscuring their license plate, hoping not to get caught. Packs of bikers around Toronto have caused trouble before, and their tricks have at times been deadly. Last year, a rider was killed when he collided with a tractor trailer. In both Canada and the States, large groups have even taunted police. Here you can see them nearly run a cruiser off the road. Then moments later, two of the bikes collide. In San Francisco earlier this year, bikers also swarmed a highway.
There are about 20 motorcycles involved, yelling at motorists.
They then attacked the driver of a white sedan, who was surrounded and beaten in a road rage incident. As for what happened this past weekend, no one was hurt.
We would have liked to interview members of the lawfully abiding performance motorcycle community concerning their thoughts on the ban, but current head of state law forbids us as such. I am sure most of you watching this special report would agree that Justin Trudeau and the federal Liberals have made right in this ban, and we can all look forward to safer streets. Well, that's all we have time for this evening. God bless Canada. And all hail our Supreme Leader, Justin Trudeau. Good night, everybody.
This has been breaking news.